Stage is set. Promises to be a good one, this. Second semi-final in the women's doubles here in Houston. About to begin.
One lock.
Still Diamond Cree and Barbara Wade taking you through the action here. Japan, of course, having taken some hits really in singles, these two. Think about what's gone on in the draw there to Wang Yidi in particular.
Lock
doubles
two.
A different deal.
Exactly, and the Japanese team has so much chemistry. They really focus on doubles, and it really and has shown over the course of this week.
Oh, brilliant from Chien there. Oh, and Loftus and sprawling by it. Look at that. Loving it, even though they lost the point.
They're having so much fun. Ito. The trip's over. And they're all smiles on the Japanese side.
Play, please.
Things you don't expect to happen 4 points into a semi-final. Yeah, enjoyment's at the heart of it. I mean, I didn't expect that, but it just shows that they're relaxed here, I think, coming into this, and you've got to be when you're taking on, say, members of the Chinese national team.
On the Japanese side, we'll see Ito stay close to the table and Hayata more comfortable playing far away. Tricking the Japanese team a bit. Many times in double try to keep the serve a bit simple, but that one was very, very loaded with spin. Two righty-lefty teams are gonna go one in each corner. That strategy really works. There you go, one in the backhand, and then right at Ito.
Flip that is from Ito. Trademark.
Yeah, pure confidence.
Play, please.
Something she's been looking for.
Play,
she's
please.
Commented on a bit, Ito, that hasn't always been so happy with her serve and receive this week. Nothing wrong with that. She's out there. Really aggressive. The receive, Ito. And I guess that's the, Barbara, if you're looking at this, do you see the Japanese as underdogs in a way here, coming into this? I mean, this isn't, it's not, in terms of Chinese duo, you've got Chen Meng there, but less experienced but top quality partner as well. But for the Japanese, is this the way they've got to play for you?
6-7.
I do think so. I think that is the way to keep the pressure on. And they have to start very strong. The key to beating China, it seems, is to get an early lead and keep the pressure.
Oh, brilliant. Hayata, one of those trademark
7-0.
Forehand strikes. Seen so much of this year, singles and doubles.
Play, please.
Chen there with the signal to Chen.
Justin's team doing a great job keeping the pressure on. Their whole delegation plays so fast.
Pretty good already, isn't it? What about that accuracy from Chen Meng?
Nine-eight.
The Japanese team really seems to play with pure joy. It's like they're having a lot of fun, and that does show how relaxed they are.
Sports about being aggressive, but they're being ultra aggressive in their approach, and to do that she's suggesting to be relaxed. Again there. So loose.
You hear the fans. Know how difficult it is to close games against Team China.
They do it here. Two game points for the Japanese.
Nine, ten.
You know, Ito didn't make that shot, but it is the right choice. They're still trying to play super aggressive, and they have to. They just have to continue to stay loose as well. That's what got them here, and that's what they need to finish this game.
Lucky there, but they'll take it.
One lock.
Second game beginning here. Chinese duo again down here. Chen Tianyi serving here, beginning the second.
One all.
Positive, ultra positive approach that served Hayata and Ito well so far. Big question, of course, can they keep that level, keep that going, stay that loose?
Let. Okay. One all. Play, please.
Two. staying true there. Being pushed a bit more now, not getting quite the same opportunities these first few points to really attack. Pushed away slightly from the table there, Ito and Hayata. It's not the case so much in the opening game. We saw a lot like that of Ito being able to punch right on top of the table, which we know. I mean, she's deadly from there. And they've done a good job these first few points in the main, Chen and Chien, of pushing them back ever so slightly. Makes a difference.
That 10% slowdown in speed can give Team China everything it needs to put the pressure on.
That's rocket speed from these two.
And you see Hayata have apologized to Ito. Watch, she go straight into Chen Meng. Chen Meng standing right there.
Yeah.
Play, please.
Forehand from Chien. Very impressive.
It almost looks like that China has forced the Japanese team to be a little off balance. They're not moving as well together as they did in that first game.
As you said, Barbara, it's fractions, really. I mean, if you're looking, it's all right trying to employ an ultra-aggressive approach, but if you're doing it ever so slightly away from the table, it's tougher to execute. They've found when they've had the opportunities in this second game, Hayata and Ito, 8 game points.
11-2, game two, Xian Chen.
Runs that away. Yeah, it's just obviously very off-putting. I think it's the end behind the Japanese where it was happening.
Love one.
Cheering for Team China. Really nice touch shot by Hayata. Kept it shorter into the table, making it hard for Team China to swing. Change that the quality is higher on the Chinese team now ever since game two, making it harder for the Japanese players to play so close and so powerfully. Really, really nice point by Team Japan. Ooh, very hard fought on the defense. It didn't look like Japan was going to win that point. And really nice work by Ito and Hayata at the end to close it out.
Four, two.
From Hayata's body language, I think she knows she been a little very hard on this, perhaps a little too hard. But they had gotten what they wanted. They learned in that sequence how they can get a nice setup.
Yeah, they really have wrestled control here, haven't they? Now, a good start made by the Japanese.
Some of the same points we saw in the first game. And that's credit to Team China and the increasing spin that they're putting on.
Let 2-6.
Very heavy top spin. It's a great amount of side. See when Chen received it, just flew off the edge of the table. So much side spin.
Play, please.
Ito putting pressure on that Japanese team, using a lot of her own spin here. Not something super fast, just a lot of spin.
Timeout coming here.
Ito really changed the pace of that rally. And you see smiles on the Japanese side, feeling relaxed again. Really great touch shot. Watch. That shot by Ito, that Chomong chops from behind, gave Team Japan that opening, and Hayata took it.
Six, seven.
Big reaction there from Chomong. At the point, it's only just to go back in front in the game, but really meant a lot.
That shows the importance of the Chinese team calling that timeout and really changing the momentum in the game. Hayata doesn't miss that very often. And looks like she just mistimed it a tiny bit here.
For a while now here, Chen and Chien. Still Hayata and Ito. Designs here on a 2-1 lead.
Stop. Yellow card for time wasting. Stop, please. Okay. 8-all.
Yellow card awarded, not the first time this week for time wasting in the opinion of the umpire.
8-9.
Kind of so good at end game.
Yeah, not bothered by picking up the yellow cards. Just focused on the point in hand. They were given that, of course, delaying the server. Still took the point anyway. Good from the Japanese, resolute.
Very good point from Team Japan, staying so close with Ito. And Hayata so well placed into Chianti's backhand. That could be that short and so wide. Looks like Hayata was looking to attack and had to recalibrate after she saw the ball come over.
Yes. Game point for the Chinese. They're really showing some good resilience here. Ito and Hayata in this third game. More of it there.
Play, please. 10-all.
Wow.
Oh, she hit it as hard as she could, and it still came back.
11-10.
So compact from Chien there.
Please.
As it was fired at her by Hayata.
Team China needs to be careful not to get a red card for delaying the game.
Yeah, now with the service, need to keep the pace of play up. Second game point. Deliver when it matters.
Love one. Let 1-0.
Good opening serve by Team Japan. We need to keep the pressure.
Suggesting, Barbara, they just need to keep with these. I mean, they were very close there. Third game. I mean, the game plan actually, you do feel, you said it right at the outset, is the right one. It just comes down to execution.
Ito so confident again. Signature shot.
1-4.
And great placement right into the middle of Tian Tianyi.
5-1.
Now the Chinese team looking a little out of rhythm.
Well, perhaps not totally surprising, actually, because it's unheartable with them through that third game. So good. Well, no smiles that time from Hayato and Ita. Just earlier in the play there, we actually pick it up there a little bit later, but just kept them in the point there, the backspin, just concentrating on good length. It's clever.
Play, please.
I think of three again.
Well, Cho Meng with her own creative shot.
6-4.
That chop block. Something that we see Ito do more often, but Cho Meng giving it right back.
Yeah, very difficult for Ito there to attack off that. She tried to do.
Six, five.
So 5-1, didn't they, the tail break here?
I feel Cho Meng really turned it on when they were trailing. She's hitting to Ito. She's putting a lot of pressure on Ito. And Ito's hitting to Qian, and Qian is having trouble with Ito. Ah! Cho Meng's pushing a lot of pressure on the serve receive. Try to kind of disarm Ito from doing all of her things that she's so good at.
Switch off the flash, please. 6-7.
It's one of her best receives of the lot there, in Rita.
8-6.
On the white line, so wide.
Be aggressive on the receive.
9-6.
Catching the net on the way through. 9-6. Nima Ito here, the last few points, Barbara, has gone up a level or two.
when Mima Ito is on fire, when she's super hot, everything hits.
Four chances to take this the distance. Oh, now Hayata, that beautiful feeling on the receive. Doesn't mean anything if you don't win it, though. That's, again, here's another of those situations. Pretty much expect these two will come out firing in the fifth. The let, and she's got it.
A love one. One all.
You know, you think back, obviously, to the Olympic Games for Japan, obviously at home in the summer was huge. They spent, how much time was spent preparing for that, for strategy, and of course Ito partnering Jun Mizutani to the mixed gold. But otherwise, especially in terms of the women's competitions, it was disappointment at the game at the hands of Chinese players. And again here, therefore, Barbara, it's another opportunity. World Championship semi-final. In the women's doubles, another huge match here. Can they get the better of them? That's the question. Not here.
I'm feeling a little bit concerned about the Japanese team in this rotation. Ito is hitting to Chunmeng in the rotation, and Chunmeng is very used to Ito and able to handle her better than Tian Tianyu.
Yeah, I also like that. Nod of approval. Example of it there, exactly what you're mentioning. First time Ito was able, well, they were able to deal with Chun. Second time round, it was just too much.
Chun Meng much more used to Ito than Qian Tianyi. And so this rotation is a little bit more challenging.
A little bit lucky.
It's great play, and yeah, a little bit lucky.
Chunmeng's facial expression was absolute gold there. That caught the edge.
Again on the Japanese side, feeling very relaxed. And when they play like that, when they have those smiles and play relaxed, that's when they hit their best shot.
It's so good, isn't it? Just the pure enjoyment. Even when they've been losing points, they're all smiles. This is why they're so, so popular. And why Mima Ito we're focusing on here is such a global star. Just loves the sport, loves to play. In its purest form. Smiling like this, a World Championship semi-final, it says everything about how relaxed they are, but also just how much they love the game. Well, you talked about the rotation. I mean, it's actually, they've handled it very well. The potential issue there, and Chen Wang, again, her expression speaks volumes. They're in some trouble here. That's the edge.
And now
one inch in the decider now on that.
And after they flip sides, they actually change who's returning. So now Ito is hitting to Qian. And so it is the better rotation in quotation marks, but it really depends on performance for Team Japan. And China very, very good at the end game. We're in the middle now, but it's going to be critical very soon.
Went into orbit, the Space Center, 25 minutes up the road here, right off the racket of Qian, and puts them three behind again. Oh, now swing and a miss.
Mom, they're so happy.
Yeah, the Chinese don't see the funny side of that. It's ended on an error, but yeah, they're joyous here, joyful at being 3 points from the final now. Absolutely pumped up, raucous atmosphere here now in this fifth game. Japanese support making a huge noise here. Chinese trying to get their pair back into it.
Nerve-wracking to be up against the Chinese. And we've seen it quite a few times this competition, and they, again, very, very good at endgame, perhaps even better when they're down. It's still a high mountain to climb for Japan.
Back.
And I saw in this point Team Japan playing a little bit passive, just 10% less, and that's going to make all the difference, as we saw in game three,
6-8.
Where China was very dominant.
Play, please.
Hayata. Breakout star here. Also perfect return by Ito. Again, Ito to Qian right now. Qian struggles more with Ito's return. Chen Meng, team leader here, trying to take that away from Ito.
Oh!
And it wasn't enough.
10-6.
More Mima magic. And it takes them to the brink. As I say, raucous atmosphere here in Houston. And they're thriving in that atmosphere, the Japanese duo. Four match points for Hayata and Ito.
Never over till it's over.
10-7.
Thought it was over on that Hayata loop where she touched her hand on the floor, but Team China is always in it.
Oh, the back edge. And it's all over. Hina Hayata and Mima Ito are into the